Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Prasad Kulkarni from Agarkar Research Institute Pune, and I'm going to share you with some of our work related to fruit, vegetables and anemia. You know that anemia is referred as a decrease in red blood cells and amount of 13 gram in males as well as amount of 12 grams per deciliter in female is considered as sufficient. Any amount less than this amount is considered to be anemic. The global burden of anemia is around estimated to be 2.36 billion people in 2050. Anemia in adolescent is a big problem. Around 20% adolescent all over the world are anemic, and that amount or number goes to around 243 million worldwide. And in India, around 48% of adults and girls are anemic. That is, one out of two girls, adults and girls, are anemic in India. The anemia in adults and in India is caused mostly by iron deficiency, which is a major responsible factor. And among other, factors iron deficiency, or along with iron deficiency, there is vitamin B12 deficiency, and that is also responsible for anemia. So what we did in this work, we selected about 100 adults and girls from nearby school in Pune, and we collected socio-economic information, then their anthropometric measurements, and most importantly, we studied their habitually dietary pattern using food frequency questionnaire, what kind of diet they are having. And then we also measured their biochemical parameters such as hemoglobin, serum iron, etc. And we also measure inflammatory status using hepcidin, TNF-alpha, vitamin B12. All these data gathered, we analyze, and then I'm showing you some of the interesting results in a simple way for you to understand importance of vegetables and other, you know, fruits in our diet. So dietary source of iron comes from mostly red meat, fish, poultry, and for vegetarian people it is mostly green leafy vegetables, fruits, beans, legumes and other oil seeds, etc. So because India is mostly vegetarian country, Indian population mostly depend on vegetable, fruits and beans for their iron, as their iron source. Therefore, if you eat less vegetables, fruits, then you become iron deficient, and ultimately you become anemic. So what we found in our study, that non-vegetarian people have a better iron contents in their blood, that is, their serum ferritin is higher compared to the vegetarian people. This is obviously because they receive iron from non-vegetarian source of food such as meat, chicken, fish, etc. Among the fruits they are eating, we found that these four important fruits are mostly popular among adults and girls. They often consume amla, guava, tomato and lemon. These are the fruits that are rich in vitamin C, and they help in iron absorption and maintaining iron status in our body. So these are very important fruits. And we found that, you know, about 73% girls consume guava, 80% girls consume tomato, and 83% girls consume lemon at least, you know, once a month or more than once a month. So that is, you know, although that is very low frequency, we see that these are the fruits which are very popular among the adults and girls in Pune. So what we found that the girls, those who eat amla at least once in a month, they have better iron status, their anemia status is very low. Similarly, the girls who eat guava at least one month, at least once in a month, they have better hemoglobin status or serum iron status in there. So in these girls, consumption of amla and guava is helpful to maintain their iron levels and, you know, eradication of anemia. Similarly, for tomato and lemon also, the girls who eat tomato and lemon at least once in a month, they said that we eat tomato and lemon, their serum iron levels or serum ferritin levels are higher than the girls, those who don't consume these fruits. So this study, you know, underlines that eating fruits that are rich in vitamin C had significant effect on iron status and anemia status among adults. Similarly, you are familiar with these vegetables. This is amaranth, this is aloo or colocasia, this is cassia chakwat, this is kadai safflower and radish leaves. These are very good source of iron and other antioxidants and anti-inflammatory compounds, you know. So we found that about 51% girls consume amaranth, 68% girls consume colocasia leaves, 37% girls eat these cassia leaves. Then safflower consumption is about 40%. So all these girls, at least they eat these vegetables at least once in a month. So if you eat these vegetables at least more than once a month or twice a month, then your iron status is going to be improved. So what does our data says that? Our data says that, okay, if you consume these vegetables, see group 2, if you consume cassia, safflower and radish leaves at least once in a month, your iron status or anemia is not going to be there. So you will have enough iron source even if you eat these vegetables at least once in a month. Okay. Then if you eat amaranth, it will not only you know, improve, these girls will not improve their iron status, but they also have a good hepcidin status, ferritin status in their blood. What does this tells that? This data tells you that, you know, these green leafy vegetables, ja hirve palya bhajya ahet, so these green leafy vegetables, they are very important in maintaining iron status, maintaining antioxidant and anti-inflammatory status in your blood. So in summary, we found that the girls who consume non-vegetarian foods had significantly higher ferritin levels. The girls who consume vitamin C rich fruits had better iron status than the girls who did not consume the fruits. And consumption of iron rich green leafy vegetables had significant positive effect on iron status. So my suggestion is, if possible, eat lot of guava, vitamin C rich fruits, local fruits which are, you know, inexpensive and locally available, then consume, you know, quite a few times in a month, at least 4 or 5 times these green leafy vegetables. At least every week you should eat green leafy vegetable once in a week. So that will help you having better iron status and you will not have anemia. Thank you.